Hello, Alchemist. We're back at the Obsidian Valley. Today we are going to learn how to fish. So I'm going to take the teleport. We are looking for the lake shack. Right. I have a chimera with me. Whoop. Well, I did not mean to do that. Crazy AO. Alright, so we were at the lake shack. Now you'll notice that there are four different kinds of materia. When you're fishing, there are four different depths, and each depth you have four different fish. Each fish will give you basic alchemy ingredients, and then each fish will also grant you possibly a rare. So rares are rare, you're not going to get them all the time. But you will use these rares to make some of the more interesting and helpful elixirs in the sanctum. So I have to decide, what do I want to set this fisher as? So you have the surface fisher, you have a shallow fisher, a deep fisher, and you have a bottom fisher. And so they will be at different depths in the lake when they're fishing. So I am going to go ahead and grab a bottom fisher. All right. So each of these materia are worth 500 linden, or are 500 linden, and you can only put one materia on a chimera at a time. So if you put another one on, it'll overwrite the last one you did. So I don't recommend doing that. You're going to want four different fishers, one for each step. So I'm going to buy the materia. I also need to buy bait. So I can get 100 bait for 250 linden, or you can get 1,000 bait for 2,500 linden. So I'm just going to get the small pack. All right, you also have a fishing bait storage bucket. That is just like the food bin. You do not need it to fish. It just tells you how much bait you have left. You can also look at the tackle box when you go to enter your fisher in. The tackle box will tell you how many bait you have, and your fishing bobber will also tell you how many bait you have. So I don't need a bait bucket, but you can get one if you choose to. The VMD Chimera Sorter is an amazing tool, especially if you want to create elixirs and you're going to be fishing and mining a lot. The sorter is awesome, and I will look and see if Victor has any tutorials on VMD, and I will link them in the tutorials section. He also has a drop and go, which is also amazing. You can put all of your ingredients in it, you can put your fish in it, and it will move things into the sorter automatically, so you don't have to do it manually. So those are two amazing products from VMD, and I highly recommend that if you want to make elixirs and you want to do things like that, then this is definitely a tool you want to get. But I am not going to do that with this avatar. My main avatar, of course, does have these products, but this is just going to be our tutorial avatar. So I'm going to head out of the fishing shack, and I'm going to head down to the lake so I can do some fishing. You'll see that here are examples of the fish. These are the records for the sim. So come down and you can look and see which fish there are. I believe in the website, the Hermetica Institute website, I do have listed all of the fish. You also have the obsidian shark. This can only be captured or fished here at the Obsidian Valley. The different regions that are chimera-only regions also have their own unique fish. So maybe we'll take a tour of the different regions and see what the fish are. All right, so I'm at the dock. I am going to open my inventory. And I'm going to grab out my bait and my materia. So let's do the materia first. All right. And then I bait can. All right. So, I am going to click on the fishing materia and it's going to ask me what I want to apply that to, which chimera. Of course, I only have one out, so this is easy. But just be careful if you have a lot of chimera around you that you pick the one that you want to use. So, this little guy is going to be a bottom fisher. And yes, so that will disappear. Are a little slow today. All right, so my chimera has been granted the skill bottom fisher. I'm going to go ahead and look at his info, and you'll see that it says that he is a bottom fisher. All right, so you can always tell whether or not you have a fisher. You can also look on the website under fishers, and so we'll go to that in a little bit. I also want to click on my bait so I make sure that I have something to fish with. All right, so now we're ready to go. So I am going to grab the number of my fisher. This is the easy way to do it. I'm going to go to the tackle box and click on it, and it says enter the ID of the chimera you'll be using to fish. This is opposite of the training equipment. So we have people who are fishers. Get confused when they're using the training equipment, and people who are trainers sometimes get confused when they're using the fishing equipment. So this is we're putting the chimera ID first because it needs to check to make sure that this chimera can actually fish. And he can. So I have 100 baits and it wants to know how many bait I want to use. I'm just going to use 5 right now for this tutorial. All right, so now you notice that my bobber has popped out. It says that I have 5 casts remaining, so that's how many bait I've used. And my fisher is off and running, or swimming. He's swimming at the bottom, so I'm going to cam down into the water. And there he is. Spring druid, so he has that nice red particle line trailing him. And he's going to look for fish. I probably should have only done one, but that's all right. So he's looking. There are accessories that you have. We have been able to win in events or in hunts and things like that. So there, you may see people with a Sharkpedo that came from the Nile Guardian event. You participated in that, and then we also had. Look at that nice big catfish that he got. All right, so your chimera will bring you a fish, and you'll see that it has a countdown timer on it. Let me see if I can. Okay, so you have 5 minutes to pick up your fish, otherwise it'll poof forever. So you do need to be paying attention when you're fishing. I have been known to start reading something or otherwise distracted, and I often lose fish. So you do need to focus a little bit when you're fishing. You can still chat with your friends. I get on Facebook and then I forget that I'm fishing, but you know how it goes. So I'm going to take it. Once you've taken it, the countdown starts. Stops, I'm sorry. So I could re-res it if I wanted to while we're waiting for him to come back. If I re-res it, it'll still have the 421, but it's not counting down anymore. All right. It also tells you what date it was caught on. So, you know, you can tell how up to date your fish is by when it was caught, the length and the weight of it. The weight is what we're looking at. Oh, look, I got a boot. When you're looking at sim records, and that it's a channel cat. So weight 20, length 20, 30, 38. All right, you take that. This is a boot. Boots have no value. I know there are some people out there who collect boots and insist on someday boots are going to be worth millions. More power to them. I just delete boots. They'll also time out, so if you don't even have to pick them up if you don't want to, but I'm deleting mine. All right. So the channel cat, I'm gonna, while we're waiting for my fisher to come back, is a bottom fish, so he's bottom fishing. He can get any fish. So I'm fishing on the bottom, and I'm gonna have the majority of the fish that are collected by my chimera are gonna be caught in this region. So they're gonna mostly be these four fish, but there are outliers. You can actually get any fish. You just have a much, much higher chance of catching these fish. And then you have a very, very, very slim chance of catching the obsidian shark. So congratulations, Shimmer, for having the record for the shark. All right, so I got another channel cat. So I'm going to pick that one up. I have two more bait. So let's go down there and watch him. I love to watch them. So he's going to swim around. One of the fun things about the chimeras is they swim differently, so the different breeds have a different stroke, or the way they swim, and the different ages also swim differently. So the cheetah kind of has a serpentine wiggle to it when it fishes. They're great. They're crazy. All right, little fox. Just the details and the expressions in these are just awesome. There we go. We caught a fish. All right. Looks like a plecostomus. And it's in his mouth. He's going to come up onto the deck and drop it. And he's going to go off and get his last fish. And then I'll take you to the processing table. We'll do that in the next video. All right. All right, Alchemist, this has gone on long enough. I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. Come to the next video to see how you process your fish.